Hello everyone, myself Gajendra Sharma, Assistant Professor GCRC Engineering College. Today we are going to discuss pointers in C. So dear students, what is pointer? So pointer is a variable which stores the address of another variable, right? Pointer points the memory address, because without pointer, programming language is nothing, right? So pointer points the address, because using the address we can retrieve or we can access the values or informations. Okay, so pointers, people say that pointer is very hard topic, but no, if you have a sufficient knowledge about the structure, about the functions, about the array, about the data types, about the operators, then it is very easy, right? So how we can perform operations using a address? So pointer is a very important topic in C programming language. We can manipulate data, we can manipulate informations using the address, right? So this is the definition of pointer variable. Pointer is a variable which stores the address of the another variable. How pointer can store the address of another variables? We will discuss in next slides. So first of all, we see the syntax of pointer variable, right? So we write data type first of all, then we write the name of variable. This is the declaration of ordinary variable, but if we use a pointer sign asterisk before the name of variable, or we can use the asterisk sign after the data type name, this is the valid declaration of pointer. For example, int asterisk ptr, this is the pointer variable. Char pt, this is also a pointer variable. We can also declare this variable like this, asterisk char asterisk pt. Okay, both declaration are valid, right? Now how we can initialize the pointer variables, how we can store the address of another variables? So this is the syntax, proper syntax for this purpose. Pointer variable name equals to ampersand variable. So basically with pointer we use two important operators. This is the address symbol, or this is the pointer symbol, right? This is the address operator, this is the pointer operator, right? If we are initializing the address of any variables to a pointer variable, definitely we use the address symbol, because we are assigning the address of variable to another pointer variable. For example, suppose we have a int asterisk p pointer variable, and quantity is ordinary variable that hold the 20 value. Okay, p equals to address of quantity. It means we are assigning the address of quantity p. Suppose the address of quantity is a 500. Okay, and the address of p equals to 5048. This is the address of p variable, and this is the address of quantity variable, right? On this address, the value 20 is stored, only this particular address 5000, right? And this address is pointing the value of this particular address, right? It means we can say 500 is the value of pointer p, right? And 20 is the value of quantity, right? But 500 is address of quantity variable, right? So 20 is stored on 500 address. So if p variable, pointer variable having the address of quantity, then using this particular address we can access the value of that particular address. Okay, basically two types of pointers we use in C programming language: typed pointer and untyped pointer. Typed pointer means pointer points the specific type of data, right? Suppose you have an integer type pointer, then definitely it will point a integer type of data, right? If you have a float type of pointer, then definitely it will point to specific float types of data, right? Another struct employee, this is also a type data. If you declare a struct employee type, structure type pointer variable, then definitely it can point a specific type of data. It means structure type of data. Another way, untyped pointer can point to any data. We also call this is a generic data type. Okay, and void pointer we can use for this purpose. Right, we have an example for pointer variable, how a pointer variable can store the address of another variable and how we can access the information using the address. So we have an example here, has included stdio.h. We have a function because each and every program start with main functions, right? In this function, we declare a variable int I equals to 100, the value of I is 100, right? When you declare this variable I, definitely it will occupy two byte memory and a particular address, this is 2046, right? For A, on this particular address, the value that is stored is 100, okay? Now, int pointer variable PTR, and we are initializing with the address of I variable, the address of I variable 2046, right? Now, the PTR having the address of I, right? And on that particular address, value is stored 100, right? If you print the address of PTR, then definitely may be different, maybe 3002. And that particular address, the value is 2046, that is the address of I variable, and that particular address, the value that is stored is 100. Okay, so if you have the address of that particular value, then you can access these information using the pointer variable, right? Printf %d PTR, if you are printing this statement, then definitely PTR means the value address of value of PTR. PTR value of PTR is 2046. And now we are printing %u address of I. This will be also 2046. If you are printing %u address of PTR, then print 3020 PTR. This.